Welcome to Yes Bitch TV, honey. Yes, God. Thank you guys so much for joining me. I really do appreciate it. If you haven't done so already, please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. And also by hitting that notification bell, you'll be informed each and every time I'm uploading something new. Now, before we get into all the fuck shit, okay, because I'm going to break it all the way down. Okay, I'm going to give it to you. Okay, I'm going to break it all the way down. But before we get into all of that, I just want to send a special thank you and shout out to my panel members from last night's live. I appreciate every last one of y'all. El Teddy Official, Ebby Reviews, Really BTV. Love you guys so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you for coming through. And, you know, when we get together, it's just so natural and organic, and I really enjoy it a lot. Special shout out to our special guest that we had on from Chasing Dallas Season 2, Aria O'Hara. Yes, God, honey. I just really appreciate you doing it. It was your first time. And it was, honestly, I'm just getting used to this shit, too. I'm not used to doing panels. I'm not used to doing lives. I'm not used to, you know, having guests or anything like that. So, you know, we all learning, honey. And I do appreciate it. You were a good sport. You know, anybody else want to come on? Let a bitch know. Okay. Yes, God, honey. Now, let's dive into some of the fuck shit. Now, my channel is Yes Bitch TV. Okay. And what I mean by that is if you read my channel description, it lets you know that I'm going to get in depth. Yes, God, honey, I'm going to give you a well-rounded perspective. And at the end of it all, we're going to try to build bridges of unity, bitch. Okay? And I preach on building the bridges of unity all the motherfucking time. But how do we do that? By having conversations with people we may have a whole difference of opinion. By talking to people who don't look like us, that don't share our values or our traditions, our ideals, our interests, all of that shit. That is how we move forward as people. That's how we try to say, oh, we are just one race, just human. We are just all trying to express ourselves and be heard. And, you know, we oftentimes, and one thing I liked what Ariel said is that people really like to take a little bit of what you said and try to turn it against you with their own little kind of flair. And I live for how she put that because she was absolutely right. And I want to shout out again the panel members because I think, you know, it's no secret that we've had this discussion about what was talked about on Chasing Dallas about Ariel and all that fuck shit with, you know, killing the kids and shit. And that was one of the reasons we did want to have a conversation with her. And for me, I already knew exactly where she was coming from. I knew she did not mean it that way. There's an emotion behind it. And oftentimes when you're really caught up in the emotion of things, you end up saying shit. And I don't want to be having to address this situation again, because it's honestly like old news now, to be real with you. Like, can we just move the fuck on and handle it? But I wanted to address that last night because that was one of the questions all of myself and all the other panel members had for her. That was definitely in the discussion before we did all of this. So, and I'm quite sure Ariel knew, you know, like we didn't run down a questionnaire list or nothing like that. We were just coming off the head, but I know that was one of the issues that we did want to talk about. And me personally, I felt satisfied with the end result. You can't hate no one. You can't sit here and try to judge no one for sharing their personal beliefs. Because then when you're in a situation, you want to scream out, oh, why can't I just be me? Why can't I just say what I want to say? Everyone is entitled to feel how they want to feel. And we establish that there is a trauma that is behind that feeling. An obvious trauma. Okay, when your sisters, when your friends, when your homegirls and them is getting, you know, murdered, you're going to feel some type of way. And you will begin to generalize the object of your hatred at that moment. The same way how we as Black people, we look at all white officers and say, oh, you'll just kill us. We don't trust not one cracker. I hate to put it like that, but that's the truth. Because of the trauma, because every time we look at a motherfucker that resembles that, bitch, we go to looking at a motherfucker crazy. We don't trust them. So when you have people that have the motherfucking nerve to get on my channel, in my chat, in my comments, and flat out disrespect someone because she may have a difference of opinion than you, I know that you guys are used to these messy, disgusting, evil, shisty, fraudulent, scamming, raggedy motherfuckers on these YouTube streets. These real angry, just sinister, raggedy bitches. And I'm generalizing. I'm not being specific because I don't have time for fuckery. My channel is not built on the heels of drama, chaos, and fuck shit about a bunch of fucking nobodies who that this is all they have in the end. That's not what I represent. On my channel, if I invite you to come on, I want you to be your real, true, authentic self. I want you to speak your motherfucking truth, no matter who it may hurt. All I ask is that you be respectful while you do the shit. And some of the things that you raggedy, sorry, evil, sinister, cunt bitches, yes, God, honey, had to say was just, you know I'm gay, right? And I defend the spectrum. You know that, right? Y'all do know that. How many risks does it take till you break, till you figure that he's fucking gay? Dun, dun, come on, little Kim. Like, how many red, like, come on. So to think that you can get on my channel and start talking about, you know, someone's sexuality or someone's sexual orientation, you have to be fucking kidding me, bitch. Again, I am not these other YouTubers out here that get off on fuck shit, hateful rhetoric like that. I don't get off on that. I actually try to combat motherfuckers like you all the time. Now, you're going to say, well, you talk about how you love people when they speak their mind, but we were just speaking our minds. Bitch, no. You are speaking from a place of hate because that child said something that you didn't agree with. How do you think she feels? See, you'll never know anything until you have walked a mile in someone else's shoes. But let's be honest here. If you ain't nowhere near the trans community at all, you'll never be able to experience what that is, no matter how many pumps you put on, bitch. No matter how many, no matter what you do. If you ain't actually living that particular experience the same way as being Black, if you ain't Black, you just don't fucking know. So, fuck you. I mean, you're just never gonna know. So to get angry when someone is speaking on how they feel, and let's be honest here, any mature person that is at least 21 and over should be able to know that that wasn't how she said it is not really how she meant it. And I'm going to say something real controversial here. I'm not here for women feeling the need to always, when you get in your feelings and you're dealing with someone that is trans or someone that is of the spectrum, you always want to hit below the fucking belt by trying to call them out. Oh, you trying to talk about a real woman and all this kind of stuff. Girl, you know that's a trigger, girl. And everything, a lot of the hateful shit that y'all was motherfucking saying in the comments, you deserve to get your asses cussed the fuck out. You deserve to get your asses cussed the fuck out. Real shit. That, why you think I let it go on? I wanted her to read you motherfuckers for filth. I didn't have enough time to go back and forth with comments. Again, I'm just trying to get used to the StreamYard service shit. And I don't have time when I have someone on. I'm not trying to read all through the comments, especially if there's some hateful shits. Now, I want to shout out the good comments, the people that were respectful. I appreciate y'all. But this message, this is a warning. This is to let you sorry motherfuckers know that that's not how I roll on my channel. Those comments will remain. Because I just like Trump, I appreciate Trump because now we know how many other people out there feel this way. We know that there's still discrimination. We know that there's still going to be some hateful fuckers out there. You're going to speak on how you feel. And then let me address these assholes too. A lot of y'all had the nerve to say, oh, well, y'all are just up her ass. Y'all are the panel. And, you know, we feel, you know, disrespected, yada, yada, yada. Whatever the case may be, let me tell you something, bitch. Ain't nobody finna come on my channel and disrespect me or my motherfucking panel mates. A guest, a person in the chat, it don't fucking matter. If it's on my platform and a guest or a person in the chat is gonna be disrespectful, I'm going to address your motherfucking ass on live. Okay? So, this is another thing. When we're conducting these panels, let me speak for myself. When I'm conducting these panels, I try my best to be as professional as possible. My job, not my job, but who I am at heart is someone who is always trying to be understanding to the person or persons that I am talking to. Again, building bridges of unity by having open dialogue, by having these conversations that are going to lead us to the bridges of motherfucking unity, bitch. That's why can't nobody ever have nothing. Because there's always a group of sorry motherfuckers out there that's going to be trying to be disrespectful. Do you think that when people come to Oprah's show, they cuss, or when they did, she ain't got no show no more, but when Oprah had a show, you think one of her audience members was going to get up and disrespect a guest? Or disrespect one of the people that's on her on the couch, on The View? You got to be fucking crazy, bitch, and out of your goddamn mind. I guess that means the same thing. I'm tired, y'all. Fuck it. I'm going to fuck in on you hoes today. Because I don't like no disrespectful ass motherfuckers. And we ain't up nobody's ass. We don't give a fuck about none of that shit. You think we get paid for this stuff? Hell no, we do this because we like to fucking do it. We're interested in the shit. And if you ain't, then click off, unsubscribe, mute my ass. I don't give a fuck. Get the fuck on, bitch. We don't play that. Everyone is equal. You can speak your piece or speak your motherfucking evil. I don't give a fuck. Speak your mind. That's what the fuck I ask. I appreciate her for being authentic. I appreciate for being herself. I appreciate the emotion behind it. Again, like I always talk about on my channel, bringing awareness to, like, we all know what oppression feels like in some way. The black community, most oppressed in throughout history. But now we got blacks, we have black gays, black trans, all of that stuff. We fall under the same umbrella now, whether you like want to accept it or not, bitch. We are 10 times more likely to be killed than most of our just regular straight heterosexual counterparts. Just for being us, being bullied and picked on, just for being us. Oh, black? Okay, that's cool. But when you're black and gay, bitch, that's two double whammies on your motherfucking ass. Oh, and don't be black, gay, and trans, because, bitch, that's the trifecta effect on your motherfucking ass. Again, we want everyone to feel sorry for all these other social groups that have all these injustices going on in their motherfucking cultures and their lives and their times, all that shit. All we ask is that, bitch, we be considered for the same thing. That's what I got from the discussion of with Ariel O'Hara. And I find it also disrespectful when, you know, fuck it. I said what I had to say. I'm over it. This video lasted a little longer than I wanted it to. I feel like I addressed what I needed to address. Again, I appreciate my panel members. I felt like we did a great job. Ariel O'Hara, I appreciate you, girl, yet again. Thank you, thank you, thank you. To all the chat members, I do appreciate you guys. But come clean or don't come at all, bitch. True T. True T. I'm just letting you guys know now, because for the next time, I'll be just deleting motherfuckers. And then blocking all you hoes, because I don't have time for stuff like that. This isn't some we're not at the Piggly Wiggly, okay? We're not doing fucking interviews behind the Piggly Wiggly with a 2006 Metro phone, bitch. No, we were on motherfucking the StreamYard service, hoe, live. Do you think we got time to listen to? You don't want to. It's simple, bitch. It's simple. If you don't want to be somewhere, guess what you can do?